Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of a rubber stamp. And then later, I'll show you how to stamp it onto an image. This is an update of a tutorial I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. Make the width 1550 pixels, the height 870 pixels, and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open the Flyout menu, choose Black, and click OK. Open your Horizontal Type tool and choose a font. I'm using Stencil Standard Bold. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make it size 100 points, sharp, and center alignment. Click the color box to open the color picker. Pick a bright red. You can always change its color later if you want. Its hexadecimal code is FF and 4 zeros. Then click OK. Click the center of your document and type out your text. Next, we'll create a frame that will surround it. Open your Move tool and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Click the Rounded Rectangle tool and choose Shape. If you're working on CS5 or earlier, the Shape tool is here. Click the Fill box and click the thumbnail that has a red diagonal line across it. This is the No Fill icon. Click the Stroke box and click the bright red color. Make its width 10 points and the radius 75 pixels. Click the gear icon and tick Unconstrained. Go to a corner and drag out the shape to the opposite corner. To remove the work path, press the Escape key on your keyboard twice. To center your text and frame, Shift-click on your text to make that layer active as well. Open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select it all. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Merge the two layers by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Brush Strokes folder and click Spatter. Make the spray radius 16 and the smoothness 8. Then click OK. Presently, the text is too ragged, so we'll confine the spatter to just inside the original text's shape. Go to Select and Color Range. Choose Red. This selected everything that's red. Now that we have a selection of the spattered text and frame, we can trash the composite snapshot. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the original text and frame. Next, we'll make our rubber stamp look worn by adding scratches to it. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. Click the Gear icon. I'm opening a series of scratches created by Doghouse Design Studio. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. When you see this message, click OK to replace the current brushes with the scratch brushes. I'll click this one, but feel free to experiment with them. Notice they're all 2500 pixels, which is huge, so let's reduce the brush's size. Make sure your caps lock key is not on, and press the left bracket key on your keyboard a number of times until your brush is approximately this size. Click a few times over your rubber stamp to make the scratches appear increasingly dark. To make it easier to navigate over your document, open your Move tool by pressing V on your keyboard. If you want to change your stamp's color, click the adjustment layer icon and click Solid Color. By clicking on the color slider and the color field, you can change its color. Then click OK. To see your rubber stamp, we need to clip the adjustment layer. To do this, press Ctrl-Alt-G on Windows or Command-Option-G on a Mac. Double-click on the adjustment layer to open the color picker. Continue to play with the colors until you have a color you like for your stamp. Since I want the original red color from my stamp, I'll click Cancel and trash the adjustment layer. Next, we'll place your rubber stamp over an image. Go to File and Place Embedded. Find the location of the file you want to place the rubber stamp onto and click on it. Then click Place. To resize it, go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the transform and drag it. Then press Enter or Return, or click the check mark at the top. Drag the layer below your rubber stamp and make the stamp active. Change its blend mode to multiply so we can see the image under it. If you're using the adjustment layer for the stamp's color, just change the blend mode of the adjustment layer to multiply. Use your transform tool to adjust its angle and size. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.